Sometimes you've been working head down too long that you look up and you realize, wait, isn't that the finish line? I'm Chris C, founding director of the Cardstack Project. We've been working towards the Boxel release, which is the user-facing product that leverages the Cardstack framework. And I want to give you a quick update on where we are in terms of release planning and getting users onto the platform. So for those who are new here, I want to catch you up on like what we're doing, why we're doing what we're doing. So let's jump right in. What we have been dealing with is a world where this layer software stack, which is built on the cloud, have database API IDEs and different type of Git workflows, that's been a pretty dominant model. I think since the beginning of 2010s to this year, that is where most of the cloud software you use, SaaS software, consumer software, is structured this way. There is a UI layer, there are backends called API or databases, and obviously there's the cloud that hosts them. This architecture is quite complicated, so it ensures full employment for different principal engineers, tooling, front-end developer, architect for distributed system, site reliability engineer, something that is, you know, makes it so that when you want to build any serious software, you need to get a big team together, whether that's VC-funded or otherwise, or work for a big fan company. That's really the predominant model. And what we've been working on Cardstack is to say, if we choose a subset of technology that is modern but more opinionated, then maybe we can get a single developer a chance by compressing this layer into a seamless layer and have a developer who knows TypeScript, which is both UI and API, and Node.js, you can use TypeScript, to be able to build software just the same as, from a user point of view, as those layered cloud big expensive SaaS software. The idea here is that this seamless software stack can be further compressed into a kind of substrate, not just different pieces that you need to have a big team to coordinate, but just one unified substrate that underlines everything you do. And that's essentially what we call composable software at Cardstack. And this is a purely a development framework, not really a product thing, focusing on just the developer syntax, the ability to have your TypeScript code generate databases, generate APIs with you just typing what looks like front-end code, but underneath is actually doing all the stuff that modern cloud software needs to do. So with a composable software stack, let's shorthand for Cardstack, then you can imagine new things. You can say, what can I build on top of this composable software stack? And obviously, apps was what we imagined to do. So SaaS apps and stuff like that. But more and more people say, could you build AI application on top of it? So AI plus apps are currently quite separate. Right now, you have web apps that are serving different functions like Notion, Airtable, Salesforce, different vertical applications. And then AI chatbots and like ChatGPT are kind of separate. They don't really overlap. People use both. They have subscription to both, but they're kind of a different thing. But you're seeing new applications emerge just like VC or Replit Agent, where people are using AI to create apps. So they're starting to have some crossover between, are we going to use app that's professionally built in the traditional layer software full stack way, or are we going to generate the software? And that's the current conversation about would AI replace our engineer and people would just make their own software. There's some truth to that, but we'll get into that. So from a Cardstack point of view, we're building an application called Boxel, which is about hosting app. It's both a development tool for apps and also a deployment environment for the apps you've built in this kind of uniform environment. Look at it as a Salesforce, where once you develop your application, you can deploy your app to the Salesforce platform, and those apps have access to all the data you're already there. It's a very nice experience. But we also understand that there is an AI component that's really important, that it's not just about adding AI to an existing app or having a chatbot do all the stuff that you used to do apps for, but we want to build in the AI capability as almost like a sidebar, a capability that is available to all the apps on the Boxel environment. So what we're trying to do is combine AI and app to allow you to do AI apps. Now, AI apps, what does that mean? It really means a bunch of possible things. It could mean that you're using, building apps that generate images or generate songs. So that would be AI generation app. You see a lot of people working on AI apps that will generate reports or analysis and stuff like that. Those are AI generation app where the user use it with anticipation that AI is the main features. There's also apps that are creating apps using AI, creating and remixing app. So those are the Replit agents or the cursor, where you're using application with the goal of generating code. Those code becomes applications. There are apps where built-in AI function that's quite hidden. So something that would be helping you analyze your content and suggest SEO. They may not look like a chatbot, but they're using AI function to come up with keywords, but it's hidden and kind of built in into a more traditional app experience. And also the other thing about apps is finding apps. So if you're like, oh, I just want an app that does something. Right now, everybody generate all these apps from scratch, but if someone already made an app or deployed it, AI can help you just find it. Hey, have you thought about this tool? So all of these components are going to be available within the Boxel environment. Because of the seamless composable stack, we can build these different types of way of using and combining AI with existing apps as built on the Cardstack framework in all the ways. And that's essentially what we're going to be launching very soon, which is a new homepage for Boxel, the product. This is less technical than Cardstack, which is focused on developer, which is allowing people to compose their own software, whether it's composing from scratch or from existing component, tapping into existing tools and units of composability, like things have been submitted that you can kind of mix and remix. I'll talk more about that, about, you know, the Boxel websites and how we are positioning this within the AI apps market. So Cardstack is the platform. So that's the underlying runtime and all the stuff, the technical bits that allow us to do full stack development looking thing in a much simpler way. Boxel is a product. The first version is going to be a playground, so you can experience the Cardstack seamlessness, and you can also play with apps we've built on them. So let me show you a set of workspaces that may not be public, but it allows you to see cards that we've experimented with and built over the time. Some of them you have seen. It's really performant, allows you to really look at different things. There are blog apps, you can click on blog posts, and obviously these will look better as we improve them. But basically there's an entire environment of all kinds of things that you can build, and these are the things that some of them we're gonna make it to the end user environment. I've also built in my own private workspaces, things like a book recommender. So I told them I like this Steve Jobs book, and the AI actually generated the Elon Musk book and the Innovator books and Think Like a Rocket Scientist book. So these are way of showing different type of applications. Some of these apps, for example, let me see, the event app, this entire template, the Neon Flamingo figure, this entire template, what you see is all AI generated. So we can also host AI apps and create recipes and make reading lists. So there's a lot more going on. Obviously, you can dive in and actually see how the implementations of certain things are written and see the actual undercode for it. So this would be the Boxel experience that is also exposing some of the Cardstack capability. And that's the combination of the playground and the platform. So in a ideal world, we'll be releasing the platform first and let people develop application, and then the playground, which is the end user, later on. But it turns out that to do the playground, we needed a lot of features in the platform. So the framework for writing these cards in TypeScript, the runtime to actually run them and index them, and so that you can query and search them, and then a tool to integrate with most developers' workflow, VS Code, which also works with AI generation tool like Cursor. I have a demo of that, how you use Cursor with live cards being editing a template in a few days. And that type of capability is directly feeding into the playground, the Boxel application, where we're building on top of this platform to build you the workspace experience, to iterate on improving our AI assistant, which taps into models like OpenAI and soon the Claude Sonnet system, and also building a bunch of example cards and app. You can see how it's done. Those two things just happens to be something we need to do together. So we made improvements to the platform as we're building Boxel app product and building cards on top of it. The good news is that both of these things are like maturing and being ready together. So I'm pleased to announce that the platform, Cardstack, and Boxel, the application, the product, is launching together in 30 days. I'm serious, 30 days. We, based on our planning and based on our sprint planning, we believe that we could get early users into our platform, play around with example card, code new cards, find and give us feedback on it in 30 days. And that is the first release. And there will be more releases coming soon that we have planned, which is adding probably feature you expect, the ability for you to create cards within your playground, and you want to maybe want to submit it and share with other people to build that catalog, to community catalog. You may want to sell some cards or even prompt. They've created an AI app. You have optimize certain workflows, you want to have other people buy it from you. And we have a credit system that's launching with the platform that allows you to use those credit, kind of like Robux, to buy other things in the catalog. So the catalog release is coming soon, and that allows sharing of cards among the community. And obviously, we're starting with fiat payment using Stripe and credit card to pay for AI credit, because AI is still quite expensive. The cost is coming down, but you still need to make sure that if people are doing a lot of generation, that they have a wallet. So you can use stablecoin or redeem your reward token, community token like card, to actually use the AI assistant and other features. And so those things are in the future. The plans of exactly the timeline and what's included in the Plaza release and the protocol release will be TBD. We'll give more feedback. But let's just focus right now on the fact that we're going to put this together in 30 days. And then as the day goes by, I will share more in progress demos of what the application is looking like, how it's shaping up, and also kind of prepare the users that's come on our system to know where to look, what kind of feedback we're looking for, so we can improve this application before we kind of go on a wider general availability for beta users. So this early access preview is extremely exciting, because there's a lot of code that allows us to ship this platform plus playground, or this product plus framework, Boxel and Cardstack together for the first time without user needing to install it. I know community members have run their own instance of Cardstack on their local computer. Being an open source project, MIT license, that's always been possible, but we want to get more people to experience what does it mean to build composable software on top of this seamless, compressed, and dense stack that allow you to build in a uniform way a lot of application on top of a very common architecture that competes well with the SaaS and cloud application today. There will be more information and sharing and social media posts as we get ready to get this launched. So I just want to share this update with you all. Take care, and I'll see you on social media soon. Bye.